Hey everybody, LeetSpeed here, coming at you with another video. Yes, I'm actually going to be uploading another video. It's been a few days since the Mecha Phantom Beast deck profile I posted, whatever, which I'll link in the description, but you know, I've been kind of busy. Finals is coming up or whatever. In fact, when this is up, yeah, it'll pretty much be finals week and stuff like that, so I don't know, there's not going to be too much uploads over the next few days, but meh. I haven't posted that much frequently anyways, just because, like, I'm just doing stuff in general. Meh. That's just how it goes, though. But anyways, I'm going to be playing with Mermail Atlanteans, and oh my god, I'm sick of seeing mermails and shit. And, you know, I don't blame you, because, you know, after a while, you know, how they've been, like, you know, people talk about how they're the best deck. I mean, I could care less if they're the best deck. I mean, they could be tier 2, tier 3, whatever. Like Gustos. Yeah, I'd put Gustos maybe at tier 2 at the very highest. I don't know. But that's just me, though. But for this video, though, I'm going to be mainly talking about two of the new mermails in Lord of the Tachyon Galaxy. Well, one being, well, I think Japan's getting it as well. And an extra pack or whatever, so they'll be getting it pretty soon. But I'm speaking about Mermail Abyssbalaen and Mermail Abyssocea. Now, I briefly talked about Ocea in one of my other videos back when she was Oceabyss. So, yeah, that you probably will remember her as Mermail Oceabyss, but not Abyssocea. Obviously, you know, Abyss and then Ocea, you know, she's based on an oceanid. So, there you go. For just a little bit of a trivia for you guys. And that's pretty cool. But I'll be giving my honest thoughts about both of them. Yeah, what? In this commentary video thing about her that we call just random dual commentary. I don't know. But yeah, after the intro, we're gonna, you know, start covering that shit. So see you guys after the intro. Peace. So, today, as I said, we're going to be talking mermail stuff. Well, we're talking about two particular mermails, but that's, I guess, the same thing, right? But, yeah, I'm digressing. Anyways, we're going to be talking about Abyssbalaen and Abyssocea. So, Abyssbalaen first, why not? Because the big whale dude with the hammer, a sledgehammer, ready to, you know, tear shit up, you know? But anyways, he is an aqua monster, level 7, water, 2500 attack, 2000 defense, pretty solid, I gotta say, pretty decent, pretty solid stats. For his effect, you can discard 4 other mermail monsters to the graveyard. Special summon this card from your hand, and when you do, target cards your opponent controls up to the number of mermail monsters in your graveyard, if possible. This card gains 500 attack, and if it does, destroy those targets, if any. You contribute one other face-up attack position mermail monster. This card gains the following effect this turn. At the start of the damage step, if this card battles a defense position monster, destroy that monster. Alright, so his effects, pretty much his that effect right there is just, you know, blow up something, hit something in defense mode and just instantly destroy it. Not as good as, like, Mystic Swordsman level 2. Oh my god, Mystic Swordsman level 2. He not only although it had to be face down, I mean, it was really good because a lot of people could probably just be setting cards and stuff, but anyways, you can discard 4 other mermail monsters to the graveyard, special summon discard from your hand. Now, that right there, that first part, I'm pretty sure everyone got turned off because of that. I mean, not because of the effect. His effect, you know, blows stuff up, you could have any mermails in your graveyard. I mean, that's a really good effect. But I kind of wish that, you know, that could have been, like, done, like, earlier, I guess, because, you know. But the thing I don't like about this is that, well, not so much that it has to be only mermails. I mean, you could play around it, but it's got to be four. I mean, if it was, like, three, I mean, you know, three would have been okay, because, I mean, you know, three would have been fine, because you'd blow up at least three cards, and you're constantly searching for mermails anyways, especially when it's, like, megalo and stuff like that, but I don't know. It just seems really difficult to do, and I wonder, like, if it's really worth it or not. Like, I say that because when you look at, you know, Megalo and Lead, yeah, you could discard other water monsters, but what you have to do with Abyssbalaen, they have to be mermails, which, you know, this guy was obviously built for pure mermail. That's fine. That is perfectly fine. I have no problem with that, but the effect is really difficult to pull off. In fact, even more so because you can't search for this guy. If you could search for him, you know, maybe you can do it, but I don't know, because the thing is, what I'm thinking is, since it has a four other mermails, I think you can discard other copies of himself. So, like, if you happen to draw, like, two and then some other mermails, you can pitch one of the other Abyssbalaens and the three other mermails to summon him. But then again, that's requiring you to run three copies of this guy just to get his effect that you might get to work, because this card can be stopped by, like, Solemn Warning, because you're revealing it after you discard four mermails, and then, you know, the effect Veiler for when he does get summoned. So you have to be kind of, like, it's really risky, and I think for no reason, really. Like, if it was so that, you know, your opponent couldn't activate any cards or effects in response to these effects, I mean, that would have been a bit better, because, you know, you're pitching your whole hand. I mean, your opponent shouldn't be able to stop this here, right? But I don't know. Right now, he is very meh-ish. Like, he's got a really good effect, but just the restriction on, like, his effect, it's really difficult. I mean, even if we're talking pure mermail, I think it's really hard to do. I mean, you can run, you know, you run salvage and stuff like that, but I don't know. This doesn't seem worth it at the moment, but not just me, though. Anyways, for the other mermail, Abyssocea, mainly going to be focusing on her because of something else I want to talk about in this video. Mermail Abyssocea is a water aqua monster, level 3. Attack of 1100 and a defense of 1900. Deadass, but I'm digressing again. Perfect. You can target one mermail monster you control. Special summon any number of level 4 or lower mermail monsters from your deck whose combined levels are less than or equal to the level of that monster, then send that monster to the graveyard. You can only use the effect of Mermail Abyssocea once per turn. Alright, so as you guys know, with the mermaids, all the level 3 mermaids in some way special summon mermails from somewhere. Mermail Abyssbalaen summoned from the deck when destroying some of the graveyard from the field. Abyssgoon, when discarded, she brings one back from the graveyard. Abysshild, whenever she goes to the graveyard, even, you know, like Dandelion, you get to special summon any mermail monster from your hand. And then Abyssdyne, when she gets special summoned by a mermail monster's effect, she can bring back a mermail monster that's level 3 or lower. So, yeah, all of them have some kind of effect that special summon other mermails. This one's a little bit different because, yeah, it special summons mermails from the deck, but you could potentially summon more from the deck. You summon a multitude from your deck that are level 4 or lower. And this is actually really good because of Abyssteus being a card, you know, and, like, what I mean is, you know, you use Abyssteus effect, you know, pitch a water monster, summon Abyssteus from your hand, then use Teus effect to search out Abyssocea, then you normal summon Abyssocea to the field, you activate her effect targeting Abyssteus, then you special summon two other. You can either summon a level 4 and a level 3 mermail, or you can summon two level 3 mermails. So you're probably going to do the two level 3 mermails. Why not? So you can get out, like, Lind, Goond, Hild, Dine, or another Ocea, because you can actually summon another copy of herself, even though you can only use that effect of hers once per turn. But, you know, that's fine, because then if you have three monsters, you can overlay them for Abyssdrite. So you can actually make Abyssdrite, you know, you can exceed Abyssdrite and very easily when you combine, you know, Abyssteas and Oceabyss together. And I think late game, that's actually very good, even though it's not the most practical play. It's still a play, and honestly, it's a lot of fun to do if you can do it, so props to it. But the reason I'm mainly talking about this card or whatever is because, you know, people have been talking about, well, it's interesting. People have been talking about a Tidal Mermail. I prefer to call it Tidal Merlantians because in its simplest form, that's what it is, isn't it? It's Mermail Atlanteans. But anyways, I'm digressing again. With this Tidal Mermail thing, like, I've thought about that, and I've actually used Tidal and Oceabyss off camera. Like, I actually had been playing them in my deck before, like, for a while, and then I took them out. I took both of them out. I did not run the baby Elemental Dragon or Dragon Ruler stream, because, I don't know, I felt like I didn't need it, but who knows. Like, that's still up for testing. I mean, there's a lot of, like, the thing I love about this archetype is that there's a lot of stuff you can do with it. It's like with Gusto, you can do a lot of stuff with it. You can mix it with other archetypes, you can play it by itself, etc. You can do a lot of stuff with it, and there's combos, like, up the wazoo with this archetype. Even if you play pure, there's a lot of combos you can do, and Oceabyss does allow for combos whether you're playing pure build or maybe not the pure build. But mainly there was a video I saw, a deck profile. Well, there were several I saw afterwards, but there was one I particularly saw on the channel of SlimX Team Symmetry. I guess I'll link the video too, I guess. Now, the guy, Andrew Dew, I think, he was running Mermail Atlanteans, but he was running Tidal. Now, he obviously, Tidal being the new card in Lord of the Tachyon Galaxy, you know, it helps Mermail Atlantean decks just swarm the field faster. It lets you combo with some of your other cards like Abyss Goon and stuff like that. But the guy was running Abyssocea at one. He was running one Abyssocea, and he was running three Abyssmander. And I was like, holy crap, what? I was like freaking out. I'm like, what the heck is going on here? What am I seeing? I am seeing Oceabyss and Abyssmander in a Mermail Atlantean deck? What is this madness? It sounded like something I would have done, but yeah, and well, I ran Oceabyss in my deck, but still, that's beside the point. I was just like, whoa, seriously? And he got 8th place in this box tournament thing or whatever, so that was like kind of cool, but I don't know, like, people in the comments are saying he was like an asshole or a cheater. Or I don't know. Like, I don't know the whole spiel with that. I mean, I don't live in that area, so that's not my concern, honestly. But anyways, one of the combos he talked about in the deck was the use of Mander and Oceabyss with Tius. Now, I guess I'll explain what he did, and of course he explained it himself, but you know, I'll explain it for you guys as well. So what you need to do is have Abyssteas in your hand. You have Abyssteas and Abyssmander. You pitch Abyssmander to the graveyard to summon Abyssteas. Use Abyssteas effect to search out Abyssocea. Then you normal summon that Oceabyss from your hand. Then you banish Abyssmander from your graveyard to increase all of your mermail monsters level by either 1 or 2. You're going to be picking 1 at this point because your Teas will be level 8 and your Oceabyss will be level 4. So use Oceabyss effect, target your Abyssteas, then you summon out either he summoned out 2 Manders, and then or just any 2 level 4 mermails, and then you overlay Oceabyss, which is level 4, and the other 2 level 4 mermails to make a first turn Shockmaster potentially against like E-Dragons or something like that. So that sounds kind of cool, and I don't know how consistent that is. So I mean, it sounds like it could work, but that's assuming you go first and stuff like that. So I don't know. I mean, there's like a lot of other combos you can do, but this is something that, you know, I already have a Tidal Mermail deck put together. I've been doing some research for that stuff, so I'll show you guys like what I've got going, you know, what I've got going with it or whatever later, maybe in the next video or maybe the video after that. I don't know, but let me know what you guys think about this idea. You know, these two mermails and then this whole Tidal Mermail thing. Like, do you think that it's going to be a very viable build in this format with Dragon Rulers, Prophecy and shit running around? You know, let me know, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.